Hello friends, in this video, I will discuss about turbine section of the gas turbine engine. A turbine transforms a portion of the kinetic energy in the hot exhaust gases into mechanical energy to drive the compressor and accessories. A turbine section consists of four basic elements, a case, a stator, a shroud and the rotor. You can see here in this picture, a turbine case, turbine stators, shroud and rotor of the turbine section. Turbine case, you can see here the picture of the turbine case that encloses the turbine rotor and stator assembly and provide either direct or indirect support to the stator element. A typical case has a flanges on each end to provide attachment points to the combustion section and the exhaust assembly. Turbine stator, in this picture you can see a turbine stator. And in the second picture, you can see how turbine stator direct the airflow to the turbine blade at an appropriate angle. So the turbine stator element is most commonly referred to as the turbine nozzle. However, the stator element can also be called turbine guide vane or the nozzle diaphragm. The turbine nozzle is located directly aft of the combustion chamber and immediately ahead of the turbine wheel. Because of its location, the turbine nozzle is typically exposed to the highest temperature within a gas turbine engine. The purpose of the turbine nozzle is to collect the high energy airflow from the combustor and direct the flow to strike the turbine rotor at the appropriate angle. The vanes of a turbine nozzle are contoured and positioned to form a number of converging nozzles that convert some of the exhaust gas pressure energy to velocity energy. Furthermore, the angle of the stator vane is set in the direction of the turbine wheel rotation to most efficiently convert the velocity into mechanical energy. The next one is shroud. Now you can see in this picture the stator ring and shroud rings that surrounds the turbine nozzle guide vane. That is, the turbine nozzle assembly consists of an inner and outer shroud that retain and surround the nozzle vane. Although the actual element might vary slightly in their configuration and construction, one aspect is common to all turbine nozzle. The turbine vanes, nozzle vanes are constructed to permit thermal expansion. One way that designer address the thermal expansion of turbine nozzle is to assemble them loosely within the inner and outer shroud. The shroud are built with a series of contoured slot designed to accommodate the shape of an individual vane. The slots are slightly larger than the vanes to provide a loose fit. Now you can see here in this picture, a loose fit between the vanes and the shroud permit thermal expansion without warping of the turbine nozzle assembly. There is a second method of attaching nozzle vanes is to rigidly weld or rivet the vanes into the inner and outer shroud to enable thermal expansion. The inner and outer shroud ring is cut into segments. As a thermal expansion take place, the shroud expand and close the gap between the shroud segments. Now you can see here in this picture, you can see vanes are riveted or welded into segments, shrouds, and the gap between the shroud segments permit thermal expansion. Turbine rotor. Now you can see here the rotating element of the turbine section. It consists of a shaft and the turbine rotor or wheels. The turbine wheel is a dynamically balanced unit consisting of blade attached to the rotating disc. The turbine disc anchored the turbine blades and is bolted or welded to the main shaft. The shaft rotate in bearing lubricated by oil between the outer race and bearing housing. This arrangement reduces vibration and allows for a slight misalignment in the shaft. Turbine blades are aerofoil shaped component designed to extend the maximum amount of energy from the flow of hot gases. Turbine blades fit loosely in the turbine disc when an engine is cold, but expand to fit tightly at normal operating temperature. The most common method of attaching turbine blade is fir tree method, and after it is installed, a turbine blade is retained in its group either by pinning, welding, riveting or lock tab. Now in this picture you can see the loose fit of a fir tree base permit the base of the turbine blade to expand as it hit to operating temperature. And you can see here, this is an open tip turbine blade, and this is a furtry method of attachment of the turbine blade to the turbine disc. And after it is attached, then it is fixed by the locking tab. Turbine blades are generally classified as impulse reaction or combination of the impulse reaction, impulse turbine. Now you can see here the picture of an impulse turbine. So the impulse turbine blade merely change the direction of the airflow coming from the turbine nozzle and cause relatively no change in the gas pressure or velocity. The turbine will simply absorb the force required to change the direction of the airflow and convert it to rotatory motion. Now you can see in this picture, there is an impulse turbine system. The turbine nozzle vane from a series of converging duct that increases the velocity of the exhaust gases. The impulse turbine extract energy from the gases as the blade redirect the flow of high velocity gases. Reaction turbine blade. You can see the pictures of the reaction turbine blade. It produces a turning force based on an aerodynamic action. To do this, the turbine blade forms a series of converging ducts that increases gas velocity and reduces pressure. The result is similar to what happened to an aerofoil, in that the reduced pressure produces a lifting force. However, in turbine, the force is exerted in the direction of rotation. You can see here in this picture, the nozzle guide vane in the reaction turbine directs exhaust gas to strike the turbine blade at a positive angle of attack. The convergent shape between the turbine blade increases gas velocity and decreases its pressure to create a component of lift that rotates the turbine wheel. Impulse reaction turbine. You can see here in this picture that the root of the turbine blade, impulse reaction turbine blade is impulsive type, and the tip is reaction type. So most modern turbine engines incorporate impulse reaction turbine blade to more evenly distribute the workload along the length of the blade. With this type of blade, the blade base is impulse shaped while the blade tip is reaction shaped. The desired result in the uniform velocity and pressure drop across the entire blade length. In this picture, you can see a open end turbine blade. Turbine blade can be opened, open end, or it may also be shrouded. Open end turbine blade are used on high speed turbine. In the next picture, you can see a shrouded end turbine blade. It is commonly used on turbine having slower rotational speed with shrouded blade. A shroud is attached to the tip of each blade. When installed, the blade shroud contact with each other and provide support, which substantially reduce vibration. The shroud also prevent air from escaping over the blade tip, which result in increased efficiency. However, because of added weight, shrouded turbine blades are more susceptible to blade growth. So this is a brief familiarization of turbine section of the gas turbine engine. Hope you understand. Please do like and subscribe the channel. Thank you for watching.